Han föddes för 76 år sedan i Harlem, New York. Och hans mamma kom från Jamaica. Och kanske var det tonerna från dessa öar i solen som gav honom hans speciella varumärke som underhållare. Men med åren så blev de här sångerna, fick de en annan betydelse också. Han såg ju hur orättvisor, fattigdom, hunger, våld drabbade en hel befolkning. Och hans sånger blev plötsligt också ett sätt att kämpa mot den fruktansvärda rasismen i USA på den tiden. Hans namn, Mr. Harry Belafonte. Mr. Belafonte, that was a long preach in Swedish, but I had to introduce you in my way. Welcome back to Stockholm.
Thank you very much.
Do you remember a special night in the Opera House, full from roof to ceiling? The Prime Minister, whatever they were. 37 years ago, a borderless night at the Opera House. Do you remember that?
I remember it very, very clearly. It was a very historic moment. And beyond the great delight that the audiences of the Scandinavian countries experienced, it meant a great deal for not only Dr. Martin Luther King, but for millions of people in the United States of America who were caught in a desperate struggle for their civil and for their human rights. Coming to Sweden was a very, very courageous thing for Dr. King to have done when he suggested that we look to our friends outside of America for moral as well as financial support for the cause that we were struggling with. Many people in America thought that such an idea was ill-advised, that we were taking a very personal domestic issue and we were like putting our laundry in public, so to speak. And Dr. King felt that such an assessment of anything as difficult and as cruel as we were experiencing under the hands of racism and we did not have the right to vote, our children did not have the right to go to schools of their choice, unemployment was very great. People could not live or go freely to the places of their choice as Americans. And we needed to have the support of peoples from other cultures and other parts of the world. And coming to Sweden was very pivotal to that concept. In that journey, we came to two places. First was in Paris, where we were helped by a large group of French and other European artists who helped present Dr. King for the first time to the French society. But perhaps the most impressive of both was the one that we did here in Sweden. Not only did the King of Sweden accept most graciously and passionately to be the patron of the event, but the Prime Minister of Sweden was the chairman. The Bank of Sweden gladly accepted that it would become the repository, and the post office of Sweden became our mailing address. And to have all those artists from everywhere in the Scandinavian country to come together in order to say, not only do we embrace you and the humanity that you represent, but we too are part of the very same struggle. Your struggle is the struggle of the Swedish people, and we feel very much a part of that.
It's marvelous, marvelous.
Incredible.
You met, of course, afterwards, and you laughed a lot to Hasse and Tage, who were the presenters. I heard that you were very, very keen on them both. Yeah. Now, when you met Martin Luther King for the first time, how do you feel? How was he? Your impressions, the first.
When I first met him, we had known about him because the problems had just begun to evidence themselves in a place in America called Montgomery, Alabama. It was perhaps one of the most racist places in America. As a matter of fact, it was a place most unlikely for anything to start because there were no tools with which to work with in that society. It was so harsh and so oppressive. But Dr. King started there, and we heard of this man making an attempt to make a change in the way America did business with its black citizens. And he said, when he called me, that I'm coming to New York to speak to the ministry, to speak to the ecumenical community of the North. And in a church, I will be talking to many of the ministers from the Jewish faith, from the Islamic faith, from the Christian faith, from the many denominations. And I'd hoped to have the opportunity to meet with you at that time. And I told him that we could meet. We met in the basement of the church after he gave his talk to the ministers. And we were supposed to have met for what was supposed to have been about 20 minutes. And the meeting took 5 hours. And at the end of that meeting, I had made my commitment that he was the one that I would bring all the resources I could possibly find available, that I'd work with him until the very end of the struggle, and that I would never, ever leave him.
You are a world-famous entertainer, left in a way the beautiful life in Beverly Hills or whatever you stay, to work with him, partly at least. You work with him quite often.
It was not a difficult decision to make. There was no other conclusion that I could have reached. This was the struggle on a human level that was far greater than anything I'd ever witnessed, except perhaps with the great struggle in the Second World War, which had not been too long before. We remembered the great pain and the great anguish that people went through in the great struggle against fascism and against Hitler. And here we were at a new level and a new struggle, fighting against the same things in many ways, the issue of race, the issue of white supremacy, the issue of oppression. People were being arrested unfairly. Justice was not available to everyone. And the issues were very similar. Certainly they were not quite as large as the experience of the Second World War, but they were headed in the same direction. And I have believed then as I believed when I was in the Second World War, because I served in the United States Navy during that war as a munitions loader. And we knew that that war was to end all race issues. And when those of us who fought that war successfully went back to our own countries and found that the issue of race was still as brutal and as intense as it was before and during the war, we just knew that we had to go on. And here with Dr. King was the threshold of that movement. So that to meet him in that church and to see in him the remarkable intellect, his humanity, the courage that he expressed was really quite stunning. Yeah. And I knew then that I would willingly join him in the crusade. Of course, we had the foggiest idea that it would become as big as it did and that it would engulf so much. Yeah.
But still, I mean, you must realize there were a lot of progress. I mean, there were a lot of success, a lot of victories. We will talk a little bit about the victories and also a little bit about how will the future be, because unfortunately, there are still problems. But let us now see when he went to Sweden, when he went there to have his speech, when you were there singing, and to have it all over again. Då är det tid att se det här programmet. Mina damer och herrar, Minnenas Television den här gången bjuder på en gränslös kväll på Operan 1966 med i centrum Mr. Harry Belafonte.
Deeply moved, greatly honored to be in the presence of the people of Sweden this evening. Not just as an artist, but as one who firmly believes in the dignity and the equality of man. Our cause in America is an honorable cause. And oft times, when we are in the midst of the struggle for our liberation, we sometimes feel that it is more than we can bear. And it is at times like this when our friends, such as the people of Sweden, have extended their hand in friendship to not only give us words of encouragement, but to do what they can to assist us in our struggle, that we know that in the final analysis, we shall overcome. I have never had this honor before, although I have, for most of my life, worked in the cause of human dignity. But I've never had the opportunity before of introducing the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King. But he is a man in whom I have the greatest belief, and in whom the Negro people of America find a great pride. Ladies and gentlemen, the Nobel Peace Prize winner, the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King.
To the Honorable Prime Minister of this great nation, members of the sponsoring groups of this wonderful occasion, the host of artists and friends who have made this bountiful occasion possible, and especially to my good friends Harry Belafonte and Gunnar Myrdal, I am deeply moved by this magnificent demonstration of goodwill and support for the cause of racial justice in America. Never before has an entire nation come forth with such a total commitment to our cause. And truly, Sweden is a nation with a conscience. And truly, Sweden demonstrates in her life and politics a recognition of the interrelatedness of all mankind. You justify the conviction of John Donne and give fulfillment to his immortal words that no man is an island entire of itself. Every man is a piece of the continent, a part of the main. Any man's death diminishes me because I'm involved in mankind. Therefore, never sin to know for whom the bell tolls, it tolls for thee. I still have a dream that one day men will no longer see racial integration as a problem, but as an opportunity to participate in the beauty of diversity. I still have a dream that one day black men and white men, brown men and yellow men, Protestants and Catholics, Jews and Gentiles, believers and unbelievers will coexist in a world where men are judged only by the content of their character rather than the color of their skins, and where brotherhood is more than a meaningless word at the end of a prayer, but the first order of business on every legislative agenda. I still have a dream that one day men will beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks, and nations will not rise up against nations, neither will they study war anymore. I still have a dream that one day justice will roll down like waters from the Mississippi in America to the Victorian Falls in Africa, and righteousness like a mighty stream from the Amazon of Brazil to the Yangtze River of China. I still have a dream that the harmony, prosperity, and peace which you enjoy here in Sweden will become the chief export of nations the world over. And with this faith, we will be able to adjourn the councils of despair and bring new light into the dark chambers of pessimism. Yes, with this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our world into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. And the world over, we will be able to sing in a cosmic past tense in the not-too-distant future, "We have overcome, we have overcome. Deep in my heart, I did believe we would overcome someday." Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you very much indeed, Dr. King, for this wonderful speech. Thank you, Harry Belafonte. I hope you're listening backstage. We want to bid you most heartily welcome. You are tonight the distinguished and honored guests of some 10 million Scandinavian hosts, all of them wanting to express their admiration for you, for your cause, and for your way to work for that cause. Thank you very much. Jo, jag sa just det att jag tycker att vi ska hälsa Dr. King och Harry Belafonte välkomna ikväll som allas våra gäster. Så att god afton alla ni miljontals värdar här i salongen runt om i hela Skandinavien. Välkomna till Kungliga teatern i Stockholm. Till Kungliga teatret i Stockholm. Till Kungliga teatret i Stockholm. Som jag än på ålden kan, än är dess ymmare mitte sanon juri nytt. Byden antexi. Byden antexi, racka tystävet. Det är ni. Ja, hur ska vi nu gå tillväga för att uttrycka all den sympati som vi alla känner för civil rights movement? Vi på den här sidan om rampen, vi hade tänkt att göra det tills Harry Belafonte kommer tillbaka igen genom att sjunga, dansa, spela, steppa, göra lustiga miner och sånt där. Var och en visar ju sina känslor på sitt sätt. Ni som tittar på tv och ni i salongen, ni kan uttrycka er sympati bland annat på det sättet att ni sätter in en summa pengar till Martin Luther King-fonden för kampen för lika medborgerliga rättigheter för alla i USA. Postgirokontot i Sverige för detta ändamål är 90 0360 90 0360. Det är alltså ett svenskt postgirokonto. Annars kan ni köpa en skiva som just nu håller på att spelas in. Medan den här showen pågår, alltså, spelar vi in en skiva nu. Det jag säger nu, det spelas nu in på skiva, på skiva, på skiva, på skiva, på skiva. Och sen ska den skivan distribueras med en svindlande hastighet, pressas i natt, vara ute i Stockholm redan i morgon förmiddag är meningen. Och så småningom komma ut över hela Norden inom kort. Nå.
Att du kom ikväll, kära gamla hovkapell. Leve dessa starka armar som har gnidit fårens tarmar. Tack för takterna som slogs tätt med din pinne Bertil Bokstedt. Man spelar inte gärna samba på en viola da gamba. Mycket sällan spelas hot på obo och på fagott. Vi säger hej till hovkapellet och hör på Johansson istället. Blir det då tumba Johansson med hockeypuck och hjälmens spaps? Nej, det blir Janne Johansson med Clifford Fears och Alice Babs.
kan ge oss kärleken, skänker varje människa hjärta glädje, sorg så växlar den. Skänker varje människa hjärta glädje, sorg så växlar den. Hej.
Va? Förlåt, spelar jag fel? Det är lite svårt det här partiet.
Det är nog inte bra det här.
Nej, jag vet. Jag sa ju att jag skulle förnissa lådan.
Så vi blir aldrig pop så här. Så man måste modernisera.
Älskade, det finns inga moderna positiv.
Ja, men det är nog sången det är fel på.
Säg inte det, säg inte det. Vet du att för det där utseende sjunger du riktigt bra?
Nej, vi måste hitta på någonting modernt. Så det är själva stilen. Det är själva stilen och låtarna som det är fel på.
Vad ska vi göra då?
Vi borde sjunga en protestsång. Det slår mycket bra nu med.
Aha!
Fundera och veva på. Den som älskar måste lida, så den är den kärleken.
Hör du? Kan inte Karlsson komma och sjunga den där protestsången?
Varför det då?
Jag menar, han har ju protes.
Du är dum i huvud.
Ja.
Den som älskar måste lida, sådan är den kärleken. Den som älskar måste lida, sådan är den kärleken. En protestsång, ser du det, att man protesterar mot någonting?
Nej, att mot vad då?
Mot allt möjligt.
Hur då protesterar?
När man säger nej.
Ja, någon skulle bjuda mig på en öl, nu ska jag inte säga nej.
Hitta på något jag protesterar mot.
Nej, men är det någon som tar illa upp sen?
Men gör det någonting?
Är det riktigt säkert att ingen blir förbannad?
Ja, nej, det är riktigt säkert.
Men då tycker jag det är inte lönt. Kanske det ändå finns någon som blir lite arg. Polisen kanske, eller statsministern.
Menar du att man kunde sjunga något oförsynt om polisen eller statsministern?
Nej, men inte gör det väl något.
Då vill jag inte vara med.
Varför inte det då?
För jag tycker om polisen. Jag tycker om statsministern.
Nej, men vad är det de andra protesterar emot då?
Nej, det är nog sådär mot bomben och mot att vara soldat och mot att man inte ska bära sig illa åt mot senare.
Men det är ju precis så som vi också tycker.
Ja.
Nej, men då tar vi det då.
Nej.
Nej, det är nu lustigt. Varför inte?
Ser du, det ska vara något som är vårt eget.
Nej, det är nu fräckt att andra har tagit det som är vårt eget. Ja. Vad är det för ena?
Unga människor.
Nej, det är nu fräckt att unga människor ska börja hoppa oss på näsan. Vi som är beroende av det här för att leva.
Ja, visst är det.
Ja, det vill jag verkligen säga. Ja, det skulle jag vilja verkligen protestera emot.
Gör det då?
Jo, det gör jag. Det gör jag. Det är fräckt.
Nå, bättre kan du.
Jo, det... Ja, det är väldigt fräckt. Mm. Det är riktigt väldigt fräckt.
Nå, sjung.
Ja. Så. Det är fräckt.
Orättvist och alldeles på tok
att blott de unga ska protester sjunga få. Också vi.
Lite äldre och erfarna människor som verkligen har upplevt någonting av livet
borde få sjunga när vi här
med det här jävla positivet
på gatan stå. Också vi borde få sjunga när vi här på gatan stå.
Vi vill in
i helsike hellre när alla andra får gå och göra precis vad de vill.
Mer vara snälla och blott veva positiv. Också vi vill någon gång,
när det nu lär vara så lukrativt också,
skälla på allt möjligt i vårt liv.
Vi vill också någon gång skälla på allt möjligt i vårt liv.
Det är fel att stel i jorden.
Det är fel att frosten slår.
Varför är det kallt i Norden?
Varför blir det aldrig vår? Men att sol ur månen sjunga och att ändra livets gång, sådan tillhör nog de unga, det deras egen sång. Oss ett annat språk är givet, åren har oss lärt så här. Det ändå skönt att livet ej är värre än det är. Det ändå skönt att livet ej är värre än det är.
Dagen åkte min vita Cadillac ur Lidingön, stannade jag till som hastigast framför Monica Zetterlunds förchipsande chateau. Jag gick in genom rosengrindarna och fram till gurksängen där hon stod i sin lilla negligé och vattnade sina svanor, omgivna av sina favorithundar, höder, trötter och blöter. Jag frågade henne: vad tänker du sjunga på torsdag? Frågade jag. Hon svarade svartvit kalypso. Det är ett gott val, sa jag till henne. Du har inte ändrat dig, Monica Zetterlund, va? Kom in.
Negermagasin om någonting som gör en neger fin. Jag såg en spalt i ett negermagasin om någonting som gör en neger fin. Annonser för en särskild kräm på varje sida, krämen ur kind och panna vit, där man blir glad och lätt i sinnet, fin och vit i skinnet. Men i vita flaskor som jag ser varenda dag finns annonser av ett annat slag. Man kan tro att de vita har velat skoja, men de vill bli svarta med sololja. Människor springer hit och dit, och jag undrar vart. För hon som är svart, hon önskar bli vit, och en vit gubbe önskar bli svart. Well, negrernas tidning jag bläddrar i, såg annonser med garanti. Negrernas tidning jag bläddrar i, såg hårvatten med garanti, som gör ett lockigt hår rakt och gör inte folk med klass och smak. Så varför se ut som ett krulligt får? Här får du ett vackert spikrakt hår. Men se till alla moderna skönhetssalonger, går vita kvinnor 50-11 gånger, och de sitter där mest hela dagen för att göra rakt hår, lockigt som fan. Människor springer hit och dit, och ja, jag undrar vart. För hon som är svart, hon önskar bli vit, och en vit kärring önskar bli svart. Hon sa till mig, missis, du vara magerlagd tjej. Flickan i Afrika, hon sa till mig, missis, du vara magerlagd tjej. Jag ser på mig, för jag var mager förr. Nu fastnar jag i min egen dörr. Nu hoppas jag ni vet det, svarta män älskar er om ni är fet. Men längre norrut brukar kvinnor all sin kraft på att äta sallad och morotsaft. Ja, de lever på blommor och blader. Well, undra på att folk får spader. Springer hit och dit, och ja, jag undrar vart. För hon som är svart, hon önskar bli vit, och en vit kärring önskar bli svart. Jag har en lösning, och det är ett rysligt slöseri med denna väldiga energi. Det är ett rysligt slöseri med denna väldiga energi. Om de svarta har överflöd på pigment och de vita har för lite sortiment, köp inte kräm årets alla dagar, ni som vill ändra färg på era magar. Det enda helt kloka är att handla gifte med en neger och älska varandra. Och han ger dig lite granna svart utav sitt, och du ger honom lite granna. Människor springer hit och dit, och nu så vet jag vart. För hon som är svart, hon går till en vit, och en vit kvinna går till en svart. But of course.
Ja, nu mina damer och herrar, har de skandinaviska artisterna gjort sitt.
Att ni också har gjort ert hemma vid tv-apparaterna och inte glömt det här postgironumret vi talar om. Eller rättare sagt, jag hoppas ni har glömt det, för jag skulle naturligtvis gå och döma mig och säga fel nummer. Det är nämligen i verkligheten följande postgironummer till Martin Luther King-fonden. 900366. 900366 alltså. Jag sa nog fel på slutet där, men det är lätt att komma ihåg att sluta på 66. Detta är dessutom inte endast ett postgironummer utan också ett bankgironummer.
Och ni glömmer väl inte heller att det görs en skiva här som kommer ut imorgon, hoppas vi, i Sverige och även om några dagar i de andra länderna.
Nu tillhör i varje fall resten av kvällen
Harry Belafonte!
Young girls have picked them, everyone. Oh, when will they ever learn? Oh, when will they ever learn? Where have all the young men gone? Long time passing. Where have all the young men gone? Long time ago. Where have all the young men gone? They're all in uniform. Oh, when will they ever learn? Oh, when have all the soldiers gone? Long time passing. Where have all the soldiers gone? Long time ago. Where have the soldiers gone? Gone to graveyards, everyone. Oh, when will they ever learn? Oh, when will they ever learn? Where have all the graveyards gone? Long time passing. Where have all the graveyards gone? Long time ago. Where have all the graveyards gone? Gone to flowers, everyone. Oh, when long time passing. Where have all the flowers gone? Long time ago. Where have the flowers gone? Young girls have picked them everywhere. Oh, when try to remember the kind of September when life was slow and oh so mellow. Try to remember the kind of September when grass was green and the grain was yellow. Try to remember the kind of September when you were a young and a callow fellow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow, follow. Try to remember when life was so tender that no one wept except the willow. Try to remember when life was so tender that dreams were kept beside your pillow. Try to remember when life was so tender, when love was an ember about to billow. Try to remember, and if you remember, and follow, follow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember, although you know the snow will follow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember, without a hurt, the heart is hollow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember, the fire of September that made you mellow. Deep in December, our hearts should remember and follow,
Matilda, Matilda's taking money and pretending. Matilda, Matilda, Matilda's taking money and running sail across all the water. Matilda, man, hide your daughter. Matilda, oh, what a slaughter. Matilda's taking money and running and sail just to group now.
Matilda, Matilda. Matilda, take me money and run Venezuela.
Run
once again green.
Matilda, 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 take me money and run Venezuela.
Group.
Matilda, 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 take me money and run Venezuela.
Group.
Matilda, 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 take me money and run Venezuela.
And the musicians.
Matilda.
Please don't encourage them. I mean, really. The idea of going back home has somewhat disturbed them. They've been having a magnificent time here in Sweden. And they have told me that as their leader, I have done them a great disservice by whisking them home so rapidly. But you see, most of them are married. Wait till the girls you were with last night find that. Come all together, group, pull yourselves together. We must make a good showing here. Because if our program is not successful in America, there's no telling where we may all have to go to live. So come, let us do it properly. Are you ready, sweetie? I do one, four, six. Oh, one, two, three, four. Bravo, bravo. Splendid, Matilda. With the group now.
Matilda, 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 take me money and run Venezuela.
Goes on for hours. Good evening, orchestra. You've done well. Really, it was magnificent standing backstage and listening to you. I was overcome with the way you executed your responsibilities. And as you can tell, my musical training is such that never led me into the operatic field. And I've often had a deep burning desire to work with a symphony orchestra. But alas, I can't afford it. Would you be so kind as to join me in this little song we're doing? Don't laugh. I'm very sensitive. All together. The ladies and the gentlemen of the orchestra. Very simply, it's Matilda, Matilda. She take me money and run Venezuela. All right, kids, here we go, all together now. A one, two, three, four. They're not very well educated here in Sweden, are they? Come, let us give them a hand. Come, singers, musicians, all together, once more. Here we go, orchestra. Come, oboists, French horn, English horns, fiddlers, fiddlesses. A one, two, three, four.
Matilda.
Oh, look at that.
Matilda, take me money and run Venezuela.
Everybody,
Matilda,
sing the chorus,
Matilda,
sing the music,
Matilda, take me money and run Venezuela,
including the audience,
Matilda,
everybody,
Matilda, Matilda, take me money and run Venezuela,
just the audience,
Matilda, Matilda, Matilda.
I mean, really, are you sorry we came? Come, friends, really. Once again, let us have a go at it. Come, let us lift our voices in glorious harmony. Spooky from the Molda. Alspratun di Golda Molda. I'm learning Swedish. All together, here we go, just the audience. Come, the entire ground floor. All the big spenders. All together, here we go. One, two, three, four.
Matilda.
Magnificently done, Drew. Come, let us try this, the first tier here, and the second tier there. Together, they make a couple of tiers. All together, a couple of tiers, big spenders. One, two, three, four. Come. Come, my friends up there in the scholarship section. Come, all together, friends up there in the balcony. One, two, three, four. Bravo. Everybody,
Matilda,
sing the chorus, Matilda.
Matilda, take the money and run and swim.
All the artists,
Matilda,
sing the chorus,
Matilda.
Sing the bit,
Matilda, take the money and run and swim.
Just money. Too low, really. Pick another key for Monica, quickly. Kish key. It's too low, is it?
Matilda. Matilda. She took my money and went to my papa. No, she didn't, did she?
Again. One, two, three, four.
Matilda. Matilda. Matilda.
Would you like to leave it in the ladies' key, please? One, two, three, four.
Matilda. 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 She took my money and went to the
villa. Merci beaucoup, cher. One, two, three, four.
Matilda. Matilda. Matilda.
Just take your key and go to Venezuela. No, it's just not the key. It's take me money. I can't put keys in my pockets. My pants are too tight. Do we have enough? Once more. One, two, three, four.
Matilda, Matilda, she takes something and run from somebody.
All together, here we go. Come on, two, three, four.
Matilda,
oh,
Matilda,
Matilda, take the money and run Venezuela. Everybody,
Matilda,
sing the chorus, Matilda.
Matilda, get your money and run Venezuela.
Just the men now.
Matilda, Matilda,
everybody,
Matilda,
sing the chorus, Matilda. I say, don't you have any women over 40 in Sweden? Aye, they kill their women young here. All right, come, let us try women. Yes. Come, let us try women 39 years of age and below. Listen to this roar, it's international. All together, girls. One, two, three, four. Matilda. Yes, girls.
Matilda.
More than half of you are liars. Everybody.
Matilda. Sing the chorus. Matilda. Matilda's pecky bunny and run Venezuela.
A little soft. Matilda.
Matilda, sing the chorus, Matilda. Matilda's take the money from Venezuela.
Thank you very, very much. I am deeply grateful to my fellow artists who have come from all over Scandinavia in order to participate in this most important human cause. I think that I should also take this moment to thank all of the people in Sweden, the television, the artists, the musicians, the members of the committee, and all of the journals that came out behind our cause. We are deeply moved by this, and I'm sure that when the Negro people of America become more fully aware of what has happened here, they will take great heart and great courage in knowing that they have so many friends here. And we had many songs to do and couldn't get to them all. But there is one song that I was told that if we left here and didn't perform it, that we would have done the entire procedure a disservice. It will no longer be on television, but at least for this audience, someone will be able to say that we did it.
Down the way where the nights are gay and the sun shines daily on the mountaintop, I took a trip on a sailing ship. When I reached Jamaica, I made a stop, but I'm sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town. Sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town. Down at the market, you can hear ladies cry out while on their heads they bear. Ackee rice, salt fish are nice, and the food is fine any time of year. But I'm sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town. Sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town. Sounds of laughter everywhere, and the dancing girls swaying to and fro. I must declare my heart is there, though I've been from Maine to Mexico. Still I'm sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town. Sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. Yes, my heart is down, my head is turning around. Had to leave a little girl in Kingston town. Down the way where the nights are gay and the sun shines daily on the mountain top, I took a trip on a sailing ship. When I reached Jamaica, I made a stop, but I'm sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. Had to leave a little girl in Kingston town. Sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. Had to leave a little girl. Sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town.
Det var en gränslös kväll på Operan 1966 med en lång rad av våra svenska mest förnämliga artister, med Martin Luther King och med Harry Belafonte som huvudgäst. En underbar kväll. Thank you very much for that. that concert. I must ask you something about Matilda. Was this just for Stockholm you did this? Beautiful, humoristic. Let's stiff Swedes open up. The prime minister, the king. And they all sang badly, but you gave them an instruction. But before that, when I saw your arms going down in total hopelessness, these Swedes, they can't sing. But I do it again. I love that. Was it for Sweden or is it the India show?
No, it was just, I had been performing the song that way for a very long time.
Yeah. So,
as a matter of fact, I had recorded it in the United States at Carnegie Hall. And that album had already come to Sweden, so people were familiar with the routine. What I must say is that I've always believed that the power of art has been minimized by many.
Yeah.
Because I think artists and culture is one of the most potent weapons that people have for focusing on aspects of life that people don't know very much about or don't want to know very much about. Certainly when we suggested that we were coming to Sweden and to France as artists to support Dr. King and the idea of our movement, our government was very cavalier. It dismissed it as an act of oversimplification, that there would not be very much importance to it and that it would not yield any real rewards. However, the extent to which the Swedish people responded to that event, it was so huge. The number of phone calls and letters and the money that was sent and the way in which the French press wrote about the event in France literally forced the State Department of the United States of America to re-examine its relationship with foreign policy in relationship to the black citizens of America. Here we were in the midst of a Cold War, trying to fight for the hearts and minds of people. We were in a struggle against communist Soviet Union. We were trying to convince people that we were the true friends of democracy, that in our country we were the real protectors of freedom, and yet we had so cruelly treated so many millions of our own citizens. And coming to Sweden and being in France and displaying this before a public that not only richly embraced us and supported us, but when we had the King of Sweden and the Prime Minister and the institutions of government lending themselves completely to the cause of our struggle, it set an entirely new code. It set a whole new method and a whole new process. And from that day forward, we became an international body of players, thanks to what happened here in Sweden.
1966, and 2 years after, they killed Martin Luther King. May I ask you, it was a tragedy, of course. It was a shock for you, for all the world. But is it possible that that murder also gave your struggle a little bit of push in the right direction?
I think that when you have great men and women who have given their lives, such as Dr. King had done, and they're taken away just in the moment of their greatest truth, I think they become always larger in death than they were, in fact, in life. It was the same about Bobby Kennedy. It was the same about John Kennedy, who had died just before Dr. King. Bobby Kennedy, he was murdered just after Dr. King. And there was Dr. King himself and Malcolm X. And certainly when Gandhi and others of that caliber of human
in
power.
In those chaotic times.
In death, their martyrdom became far greater. Because then, once their voices were silenced in the biological sense, their spiritual image loomed up quite largely.
True.
And so large, as a matter of fact, that in the United States, the government that so cruelly dismissed Dr. King were forced to create a holiday in his name that the entire nation celebrates, the banks close, And here's America saying, after all of that resistance, say, yes, we do honor this African-American, this citizen of our country, like we honor Abraham Lincoln and others. Yeah. Really quite a remarkable story.
And now you are on a worldwide tour again. And you mentioned before the film something about singing artists' life as a weapon in a struggle. Would you say that this tour also indirectly is some kind of a still going on struggle?
I don't think it's so indirectly. As a matter of fact, I have been more direct, I think, than almost any time before. We're facing yet another crisis, and I think we have to understand that each time we come to such a crisis as we're facing now, it could be the final arbiter in whether or not the human race survives. Weapons of mass destruction are just that, mass destruction. First and only time such weapons have been used were by the United States of America when we bombed Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And to suggest that the way in which to settle grievances with sovereign states, one between the other, is to use war as the weapon to do so, is, I think, thinking that is not only fraught with great danger, but is not very bright. I think the use of intellect is highly diminished when a man like George Bush, with his arrogance, has chosen to dismiss the wishes and the hopes and the desires of billions of people around the world who say we no longer, in the 21st century, see war as an option for the settling of differences. We must find a way to do this peacefully. Now, this does not mean that tyranny and dictators and people who are oppressive and the terrorists should not be dealt with. By all means, they should be dealt with, and we should deal with them vigorously. But going to war is not the solution. Two of the greatest societies of oppression known to us in the 20th century, actually there were three. One was Germany and what happened with the axis of fascism. That took a great war and 30 million lives and untold destruction. Later, we found ourselves trying to weakly come back to some normal place for society. The second and the third was the Soviet Union, under the banner of a socialist ethic, pursuing a concept which had a lot of wonderful things to the idea of a socialist society, a classless place where everyone can eat and learn. It's a wonderful idea, but the messengers corrupted the message. The communists, the Stalinists, what they did with the gulags and the pogroms. And the other place was South Africa with apartheid. What the Afrikaners had done to the blacks and how cruelly the children were shot down in the streets. Nelson Mandela was sent to prison for life. Yet in both of those instances, both of those societies collapsed completely and not one shot was fired.
No, that's true.
Not one shot changed the Soviet Union. Not one shot changed South Africa. So ironically, it was Nelson Mandela who said, not only will we not use violence to settle our grievances and to find our new democracy, but we will seek no revenge against those who murdered our children, who put us under oppression, who imprisoned us, who denied us our rights and our humanity. We will forgive them for these transgressions and make a new society.
Will you forgive them too?
Yes, I would.
And that tour you have now is a tour of forgiveness?
Yes.
So my last question, Mr. Belafonte, must be, are you an optimist or a pessimist? What will happen to our children and our grandchildren in the future?
I think it takes great courage to be an optimist. Many people would like to dismiss us as foolish thinkers, as idealists. Somehow, if you're an idealist or an optimist, you're not of reality. Why should not optimism, why should not idealism be as real as cynicism and negativity? After all, Abraham Lincoln was a great idealist. Mm-hmm. So was Martin Luther King, the men we've just discussed, Nelson Mandela, John Kennedy, Bobby Kennedy. Olaf Palme was a man of tremendous idealism, a great leader for the peoples of Sweden, and he was taken away from us much too young. I think to be an idealist is to be someone of enormous courage and strength, and I embrace that.